Today we're looking at something a bit different. This is the Volna 9, a Soviet macro lens. It's a 50mm f2.8 lens, and according to the serial number and one of my followers, it was made in 1988, which proves it was made in the Soviet Union. These lenses were made between 1982 and the year 2000, according to my follower. And it extends like this when you focus, but it only goes to 0.5 times magnification, as is pretty common among older macro lenses. The aperture ring sits at the front, and the lens as a whole is pretty nice to handle. The most peculiar thing about this lens is the aperture. Look at how the shape changes of it when you change the aperture. In the middle it's almost like a star, and then it's a hexagon at small apertures, and wide open it is round. So you get a very wide range of different aperture shapes with this lens, and the star-like aperture, I have never seen it in any other lens before, so that makes it quite unique, but unfortunately a bit busy in the bokeh. You need an adapter for this lens to use it with a modern camera, because it's M42 screw mount, which means you screw on the lens like this. And these adapters, you can find them very cheaply on eBay, and they are good to have if you like older lenses like me. So let's take a little walk in the forest and see what kind of images we can take with this lens. Today the weather was very dark and grey and cloudy and just boring, and the summer is over here in Sweden, so there are less and less interesting subjects to photograph, unfortunately. But I try to really embrace days like this one, see them as a challenge, because if you become a good enough photographer to take nice looking, aesthetically pleasing photos, even on grey dark days like this one, then you can take nice aesthetically pleasing photos in any circumstances, in any weather, anywhere. And that is something I really strive towards as a photographer, to be able to take nice photos in any weather, in any conditions. The idea with this video was to just try an old Soviet lens, because I was a bit curious if they feel different than other lenses from the same era. And no, this lens doesn't really feel that different compared to other lenses made in the 80s. But I do have to say that the image quality is not great. It is pretty soft at all apertures. It is never completely super sharp, and you get in some situations nice bokeh, for example when you're shooting wide open, because then the bokeh and the aperture is actually round. But as you saw earlier in this video, when you do shoot at like f8, the aperture is kind of star-shaped, so the bokeh will be busy. But sure, if you get the distance to your background just right, you can get these pretty cool looking patterns in the bokeh, and that could be cool, but I'm not really that happy about the performance of this lens. I will probably never use it again, and I think I will maybe try to sell it. If you want to buy this lens to try it yourself, I got mine off eBay. It wasn't that expensive. I think I paid like $40 or $50 for it. And there are probably a lot of people living in old Soviet countries where these lenses are plentiful who can sell them on eBay. So go look there. And I want to remind you that I never actually shoot with just one hand in real life. I only do it when I have to, because I'm recording a YouTube video with the other hand. Many of the photos you see in my videos are actually taken with the two hands. I mean, it's really hard to do photography with just one hand, especially with a manual lens. But I do sometimes have to hold the camera with just one hand in order to make my videos, because I'm filming myself. Oh, it was so long ago. I was just out in the forest with a macro lens, just walking around, taking photos. It's such an enjoyable feeling, and I should really try to do it every week, I feel. Sometimes, though, I just have so many other things to do, and yeah, other work gets in the way. Before we get back into the video, I just want to mention that I have an inspiration newsletter about photography that I send out once per month, and it's completely free, and you can sign up at mwroll.com. And also, please do check out my Instagram, mwroll is my name there, if you want to see more of my photography. Since it was pretty dark out today, I had to shoot at a pretty high ISO. I shot at 800. And this is something I've learned over time, that you should never ever be afraid to crank up the ISO when needed. When I was a beginner, I always tried to shoot at ISO 100. And I even went as far as not even taking photos when it was too dark, because I felt like my photos have to be absolutely 100% grain free, so I won't shoot at higher ISOs than 100. But that's such a stupid way to think about stuff, because with today's modern cameras, especially with the full frame one I'm using, you will barely even notice the grain unless you look very closely in the photo. And the grain in today's modern digital cameras actually looks pretty nice, so even when you look closely, I think it looks pretty good. I will leave you with one last piece of advice, and that is that it is very common that you feel like you're not getting any good photos in the first like 30-40 minutes of a photo walk. I certainly felt that way today. And once you get your first like photo that you feel happy with, that you enjoy, then I think that spurs a lot of inspiration, and then you can really get going. And I usually get my very best photos at the end of a photo walk, and then I usually feel a lot happier, more inspired, and just content than I did in the beginning of the photo walk. So if you go out to take photos and you don't feel like you're getting any good ones and you feel kind of sad, just hang in there and fight for a while until you get some really good photos. Actually, this was the last photo I took today, and I think it was the best one. I really love the colors and how it looks and the composition and everything. Thank you guys for watching this video. See you very soon again in another one. Bye for now.